Hello everyone, myself Mirza Ghayaz Baig. I'm again here with a new concept, that is Remedial Mathematics. Remedial Mathematics is one of the subjects which is present in pharmacy and pharm.D. Many students in pharmacy and pharm.D face many trouble or problems with this subject. Like in engineering, students face a big problem with M1, M2, M3. So, all the pharmacy and pharm.D students imagine that this is one of the hard subjects for them, but it's not like that. Here, I am going to explain you step by step what is the process and how to score in this subject and how to pass in this subject. Before going through the step by step process, let's see the syllabus of Remedial Mathematics. In Remedial Mathematics also there are regulations of R09, R13 and the present syllabus is R16 syllabus. In R09 and R13 they consist of 7 units. Out of these 7 units they have to write 5 units, that is 5 question answers. Out of 7 question answers they have to attend 5 question answers. In this regulation, in R16 regulation, there are 5 questions and 5 units. There is no choice, we have to attend 5 all questions. The syllabus of R09 and R13 of Remedial Mathematics, like algebra, trigonometric, analytical geometry, differential calculus, integral calculus, differential equation and Laplace transform. For scoring good marks, you have to cover 5 units like algebra, trigonometry, analytical geometry, differential equation, Laplace. These are the 5 easy units in the Remedial Mathematics. For the purpose of pass, you have to cover algebra, analytical geometry, differential equation, Laplace. These are the 4 units you can cover for the purpose of passing marks. 75 out of 75, you have to cover minimum 60 marks of syllabus, then only you can get easily 40 to 450 marks. Otherwise, if you are comparing the syllabus which is less than 40 marks, then you are definitely going to fail in the subject. So minimum you have to cover 4 units for the purpose of pass. If you want to score the good marks in the subject, then minimum you have to cover the 5 units, like first algebraic. In algebraic you have to cover matrices perfectly without any doubt. Matrices, in matrices addition, subtraction, multiplication, grammars and inverse method. These are the 2 methods which are most important. In analytical geometry, circles, straight line, types of straight lines, parabola, these are the main topics in the analytical geometry. Next, coming to differential equation, there are few topics like first order, second order and higher order. Higher order differential equation, there are few steps like e power ax, sin x cos x. These are few methods that you have to follow in the differential equation. In Laplace transform, there are just 2 or 3 forms. Like in Laplace transform, you have minimum 6 to 10 formulas. You have to memorize that such kind of formulas to score a good marks in Laplace transform. The Laplace transform is totally depend on formulas. 2 topics, like the first topic is depend on Laplace transform, second is first shifting theorem. Now coming to R16 syllabus. The syllabus is consisted in the 5 units, like in the R09 or R13 syllabus, they are consist of 7 units. The 7 units are compressed into 5 units. Like the first unit consists of algebra. Algebra is consist of permutation, combination, binomial theorem and matrices. And the second unit, trigonometry. In trigonometry, there are three types, like mensuration, functions and component, and there are so many topics also. Like differential calculus. In differential calculus, the main important topic is maxima and minima. Then there are different types of equations in the differentiation, and for the logarithm and the fraction there are types of differential equations. Next, coming to the integration consists of a huge lengthy unit, which is minimum of a length which consists of a different method of integrations. Now coming to the last and the final unit, which is present in R09 and R13 also, differential equation, which consists of exact differential equation, binomial differential equation, and first to second and higher order of differential equation. These are the 5 units which are present in R16. For the students who are in R16, they have to cover this unit and fourth unit, fifth unit, and differentiation. Minimum, if you want to score good marks in it, you have to cover at least four units to score, like first, fourth, fifth, third, second, for the purpose of good marks. Here are the few important topics from all the 5 units that you have to cover at least once before going for the exam, like matrices. In matrices, you have to cover 101% primers and inverse method. Primers and inverse method is one of the most important in matrices. Next, binomial theorem, maxima and minima, measurements from trigonometry, and the straight line and difference between the two points. The 6th topic is first, second, and higher order of a differential equation. And the 7th, 8th, 9th are the methods of differential equation, like e power ax, sin ax, cos ax. These are the few topics, like in the 10th form, integration of a trigonometric function. These are the 10 in the most important topics that you have to cover at least once before going to the exam. So guys, I hope that you got a sufficient knowledge about the subject, and just try to follow the step-by-step process what I have explained in the video to get a good marks and pass in the Remedial Mathematics. If you have any more doubt on this subject, just try to comment me in the comment box. And thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to my channel, and press on the bell icon for the every update from the Mirza's Education. Thank you. Bye bye.